With the brand new release of Zack Snyder's Army of the Dead being released this Friday on Netflix, I thought, why not go all the way back to 2004 and relive a nightmare memory of this classic zombie film. Dawn of the Dead stars Sarah Pauli and Ving Rhames and is about survivors of a worldwide plague that is producing aggressive flesh-eating zombies take refuge in mega Midwestern shopping mall. Now, a little background story of this movie before getting into the review. As a kid, zombie movies were like my thing. Like, those were the movies that I would try my best to convince my parents, please let me watch the R-rated zombie movie. I want to watch it. I like zombies. I was a weird kid. I was so nightmare fueled of zombies, but I couldn't stop watching all the movies. Like the prime example, Shaun of the Dead, movie that I loved as a kid, still love today. And then there was Dawn of the Dead. When I watched it for the first time, it scared the living shit out of me. And the big reason why is because running zombies. Because as a kid, I didn't see 28 days later or 20 weeks later. I saw Dawn of the Dead. So as a kid, these running zombies scared me. And even today, like, when I think about running zombies, I actually think about Dawn of the Dead before I even think about 28 days later. So now, watching this movie tonight, refreshing my memory, it was a great old time. It brought back so good memories of me watching this movie late at night on TV, or if it was like on standard TV, it would show like none of the blood or any of the nudity, gore, all that kind of stuff. So really, this was one of those movies that, again, it gave me nightmares because of running zombies. And watching it tonight, my only word I can say about this movie, it's badass. Like, Zack Snyder's very first film, Dawn of the Dead, is a fun, awesome remake of the classic 1978 Dawn of the Dead, which, if you've not seen, is a very cheeseball movie nowadays. But when you go back and watch it and you appreciate what that movie did, for especially for horror, and that was George A. Romero, it's a great movie. Now, in this one, this remake does something that a remake, I think, should do for every remake of a movie. You take that premise of that other movie, the original movie, you can do certain characters in the storyline, but change it up. Make something new. Because the original Dawn of the Dead are slow-moving blue zombies. In this movie, they are sprinting the fuck after you, and they are going to rip you in half and eat you. Now, what's actually really funny is I had not a clue that James Gunn wrote the script for this movie. And watching it today, I was like, this is a James Gunn movie. Now, truly, it is a Snyder movie. Like, when you watch it, it's got the slow-mo. It's got the zoom-in things on little frames. They're like, why are we zoomed in on a woman stepping on a cigarette? Why are we zoomed in on a chess piece and then Ving Rhames holding up a sign saying, shoot Burt Reynolds? Like, it is your Snyder fun. It's your slow-mo. It's got the music that he always does in the movies. He's got big music moments, which, honestly, thinking about it, James Gunn also does that with his movies, with music, especially Guardians of the Galaxy. So I don't really know for this movie. It could be both of them. They're both just geniuses for fun, because this movie is fun. Like, from beginning to end, it does have that fear factor. Like I said, running zombies, it's pretty scary. An opening scene where her husband turns into a zombie, it scared me as a kid, especially how, like, white and clean her bathroom is and how bloody she is. That memory of just blood really soaked into my memory as a kid. I don't know why. I think it's just because how clean the movie is in that opening, and then it becomes super duper bloody and ridiculous, and then we get into this mall, and my gosh, the movie just, it's just fun. Now, with really looking at the issues, I mean, it is your cliche zombie movie. You got, like, your main group. You got, like, the main female lead or main dude who's probably, like, the smart one. You got a couple of them. You got a badass, like, Ving Rhames, and the guy who's, like, the dickhead of a security guard. Yeah, it turns into, like, even more of a badass by the end of the movie. Yeah, you got your badasses. You got your cool characters. You got the guys. You're like, all right, you're dead, which is totally that third security guard dude. Yeah, he totally gets fucked up by zombies. But, like, the movie has your character little traits of zombie movies. They get in there, close the doors, lock the doors. But there is one thing that this movie stands out from other ones. We got a zombie baby. Yes, this scene, oh my god. I remember watching this movie for the first time, and that happened. That really got into my stomach and twisted. Nowadays, watching, I'm like, that is totally a Zack Snyder thing. He would do that. He would push the limit of making a zombie baby come out of a zombie woman. And then also think about it, it's like, you know what? James Gunn, he is that guy. He's the guy that writes movies. Like, you think of a crazy idea, he's gonna take that, make some comedy out of it, and he's gonna show it to you. And then Zack Snyder, he's gonna film it. The chemistry and relationship, this needs to happen again. Besides all the zombie traits of a storyline, I think probably my biggest issue, which actually to a lot of people, the third act is like everyone's favorite. I mean, again, the zombies chasing these two armored trucks, it's really fun, it's exciting, again, scary, intense. But to me, it feels like the movie's very rushed. Like, it's an hour and 50 minute movie, and it rushes this ending. Like, I mean, we have our group, they get picked off, and then once they get to this truck, I mean, they're like, all right, we need to get this truck, we need to make it to one truck. Can we kill the people in this one truck? What should we do? Let's make the old man stumble and chainsaw and half a woman. God, James Gunn wrote this movie just by looking at it now. And then we get our great ending, an ending I will never forget watching for the first time, because at the very end, they all get on this boat and the end credits begin, and it's like showing the videotape of them videoing it. I was always like, aww, all the main characters died, because they get to this island and the zombies come out of the jungle and they kill them. We don't see the dog die, which I love knowing that the dog is living happily ever after, but we do see that like our cast like gets brutally murdered, and then we get the great come on get down with the sickness. It's like it's playing in the credits. It's like, this is perfect. It's awesome mixture with funny, because that's that James Gunn style right there. That's his script. Like, this is a James Gunn script, but Zack Snyder directed a badass zombie film. It's fun, it's exciting, it's scary, it's very intense. Hell, one of the most intense scenes in this movie to me is when across the street the guy with the sniper gets bit and he's turning into a zombie. He's holding up the board with the blood and the girl's downstairs. That is an intense freaking scene. I love it. I love this editing style. I love the slow-mo. I love Zack Snyder's style in this movie. It works. It's a badass movie. It's so much fun. If you've never seen the 2004 Dawn of the Dead, please watch it, especially if you want to watch it before Army of the Dead, which makes me more excited to watch that movie. I'm gonna give Dawn of the Dead a B+. So, like, I know Zack Snyder is, like, known for, like, Man of Steel, Justice League, Batman vs. Superman. Like, he's known for the superhero movies. But when you have a zombie movie coming out, a brand new Zack Snyder zombie film, I think of Dawn of the Dead. And that is why I'm really looking forward to the movie this Friday. I will watch it on Netflix, and of course I'm going to review it because I'm reviewing this movie because of it. So anyway, guys enjoy this movie review, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Bye-bye, everyone.